Your minions are sycophantic. Thank you.
Object has been ordered.
So, the guy here sees...
contact contamination.
Gogeta! My blade is drawn!
If the forces of justice are causing you... Thank you.
Construction unpaused.
Thank you.
Total gridlock here in Delhi today. The streets are teeming with people hoping for a glimpse of Arman Krishnan, the charismatic crime boss who's come out of hiding for the first time in years to catch a plane to an unknown destination. Despite his checkered history, Krishnan remains a popular Indian folk hero for defying British colonial rule. It is not yet known why he has ventured out, but whoever he is planning to meet must be very important.
Take a 5-minute break and we'll be back with some Kerbal Space Program. Yep. Welcome back. Got some Kerbal Space Program here. And on my last stream, I started a new career mode, but I've lost that. So we didn't get very far. I'll go ahead and start another new one. We can get right back to where we were. Everything default. Normal difficulty. Everything default. Sure. I didn't put in a name, so apparently that's not the first time I've done that. Playing on career mode, so we have to take contracts. And we'll launch the first vessel and gather scientific data from Kerbin. Very easy to do. Let's go ahead and start a a program here. No, we don't want money. We want the research. Okay. So for the first ship, real simple. Just needs to be able to fly. I'm just going to rush through some of these early stuff to get caught up to where we had been. Hi, welcome. Starting a new career mode here on Kerbal Space Program. Gather some science. And that's it. Now we just need to launch. Gather some science from flight. I was just saying that started the last time and lost the files, so just doing these early missions really rapidly to get back to where I had been. And that's two contracts complete. Go ahead and grab some new tech. That's all I can afford. Pick up some new missions. Let's see, is there anything I can do from the launch pad? Nope, 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 nope. That I can do. And that's about it. So after that, we have to try to orbit Kerbin. Oh, where's the escape the atmosphere? There it is. That one I can do. Okay. Build a new ship. Coupler, I'm going to have to test that to finish the contract. Keep some science in there. New science. I don't think so. doesn't burn up on us. And we are out of the atmosphere, so let's take some science here. And time warp. I'm trying to get to some cooler stuff. We're back in the atmosphere. Now, the nice thing about these pods, the Mark 1 pods, is they are weighted at the bottom, so they'll automatically turn themselves into the retrograde, which means you don't have to waste electric energy running your SAS to keep yourself pointed correctly to avoid burnout. It's nice. Yeah, we are slowing down nicely. The thing is, you gotta come in at an angle. If you come straight down, you're toast. Test on the decoupler tonight. Oh well. Well, the shooter opened at 1,000 meters. There's no reason to throw it out. Pop it at 2,000. We'll deploy it one. That way you're not sitting here for 20 minutes watching. Always think back to a KSP meme I saw. It's got the parachute deployed at like 8,000 meters or whatever. That one is going to cost us 50 years. Unlock more stuff. Yeah, we can get it all. Okay. And let's see what we got for contracts. Not gonna do that. Nope. That one we could do. Just have to take a couple of guys on a suborbital flight. It's easy enough. Yeah. It's going to be pretty much two launches identical to what we just saw. But that's really career mode for you. Terrible at naming stuff, so if you have any suggestions, feel free to let me know. If I like your suggestion, I'll definitely name the ship. And now we can throw Jeb, you've gone on every flight, but send Val and Ripney. Good luck. Okay, so our goal is just to send them up out of the atmosphere and drop them right back in. Suborbital. Should be very simple. Yeah, I did just throw it up in this area. Plenty. What? I didn't put a decoupler on there. So there's no... I'm stuck with this SRB. And I thought I had a decoupler, so I did my staging, which activated my parachutes. So I have disabled my parachutes again, and now we just have this SRB riding along with us. It's awesome. We'll still make it out, but now we got this big ol' SRB stuck on here. And SRB is solid rocket booster. And that's too bad, because this thing is going to definitely want to point us in the wrong direction. Yeah, this could get ugly. Try to keep this pointed retrograde so the booster engine there takes all the heat instead of the pod. I would like to see the booster overheat and burn off. I would have liked if I'd remembered to put a decoupler between that and the pod. Oops. My goal for tonight is to at least get to a flyby of the moon. No, yep, that's what I was afraid was going to happen. No. Okay, we're going pretty slow. I'm going to... on that. Let's go put a decoupler in. There. It's always something really simple that you forget and it completely messes you up. And look at that, I did not check my stage. So I think I'm gonna leave with my watch. Thank you. definitely not getting out of the atmosphere. Crap. Okay. I don't think I need the fuel. I think it was just because I goofed up that staging. But I'm going to throw a little extra fuel in there anyway. Let's go. The less fuel you have, the less it costs to launch, the more profit you make per launch. But that time we only made it to 32,000 meters, which is halfway, less than halfway. So it's no good. Did not need that. So, to disconnect right away at the beginning. It's really harmful. Glad I did it. All right. And we're suborbital. We're out of the atmosphere. Ah, the atmosphere. You know what? I don't think I drained the monoprop out of these. Nope. No, I did not. Oh well. I still need to test that decoupler. Okay. Okay, we've got to take one more tourist. And we have a decoupler on this ship, so I just need to remember to test it. We'll do one more flight identical to this one to finish that contract. Take the next 4 years to finish descending. No problem. You can push it a lot closer, but I don't want to. Let's do that one more time. Finish both contracts. And then next step is orbit. Next step is get the orbit. So we do the exact same launch with the other tourist. Send Jeb this time. run that test. So to test it, you just click on it. Nope, not that. Nope. Okay. That's not gonna work. Which one am I testing? You've got to activate it through the staging, apparently, to get credit for that. I thought you could just run a test on it. No big deal. No big deal. Just one or two launches. With career mode, you really have to work your way into it and earn it, and there's a definite sense of accomplishment when you do make something cool. It's not for everybody, but I'm a bit of a masochist, so I usually play games on not the hardest settings, but the most painful settings, I guess. If you've got options like this, then yeah, I'm definitely going to take the choice that requires the most effort. Okay. I enjoy the grind, you know, the incremental improvement, the tearing in the ocean. It's awesome. I don't even have any mods installed and it's doing that. That's not a moon. And I know it's spelled M-U-N, but it's an umlauted U, so it's still pronounced moon. It looks like the pod's in the wrong angle here, but once the atmosphere thickens up a little bit, it'll pull it into the correct orientation. There's really no need to expend any effort at this stage. I'm just waiting for it to get deep enough in the atmosphere to slow down. we shoot the drone, shoots slow us down substantially faster. Now we just sit here for the next 10 years waiting for this thing to land. Do I need all those parachutes? Nope. Okay, orbit Kerbin is the next big. I'm not doing any more of those tourist things just now. So yeah, let's orbit Kerbin. Do we have what we need to do this? The answer is probably. Engines without them smashing back into your core is to have the bottom of that engine slightly lower than the bottom of your core. Now we're already too big. Let's see, what's the problem? It is mass, so it is the launch pad that needs to be upgraded. And again, I'm open to suggestions on names for any of these, because I am terrible. Kill this. Orbiter 1. Right now, have to upgrade the launch pad. Did not check my staging. I need to make sure that's all set. You're choking me here, boy. Yeah, so that would have killed us. Okay, that goes there, that goes there. Yeah, that's fine. Those can fire at the same time. Okay, there we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fire the two solid rockets and the liquid engine at the same time. No, I'm not. I'm going to go put some fins on there so it doesn't flip upside down in the middle of flight. I did not I did not adjust my staging. So none of that was saved. Okay, and there we go. And I'm gonna fire the liquid fuel engine, but only just barely. I'm gonna rely primarily on the solid rocket boosters to get us up to speed. Alright, here we go to orbit. Coast until we get up there and then burn some more. 375. It's gonna be, we'll definitely do it. We got 928 meters per second in the upper stage. Yeah, we're fine. Definitely going to orbit. All right. Okay, we're in orbit. That's it. That's it. Now, I'm not going to hang out. I'm going to deorbit immediately. And did that work? Yep, that'll do it. Okay. Now, I burnt a little too much fuel getting into orbit, so didn't have quite enough to go suborbital, but our new orbit's going to drop us into the atmosphere enough to create sufficient drag to pull us out of orbit. So we're fine. We're fine. Okay, let me just speed along. Did I do a crew report from space? Yeah, I did. And I can't deviate yet. Nope. So now we just wait. Dip down into the atmosphere, which should slow us way down. I think, yeah, our first pass is probably enough to pull us out. Yeah, see, the apoapsis is already dropping pretty fast. Yeah, we're fine. We're definitely coming home. Not losing too much ablator yet. No passengers on board this one, so no drogue chutes. Jeb likes to live on the wild side anyway. And he can handle the 10 G's caused by the deployment of the primary chute on drones. Taking a crew report for the body. Okay, let's see what we got. It is. We can upgrade. Now, if we're going to go to the moon, that's what we're going to need. That. Yep. All of this other stuff is really good, too. But I'm not sending a manned ship to the moon until we get some better tech. So this little thing right here, this Probodobodyne Stayputnik, is what I want right now. And there it is. Explore the moon. Fly by the moon. And that's what we're going to do right now. This is tough because that probe core has no SAS. Okay. This is going to be ugly, but it will work. And it's not coming back. Science equipment, and definitely needs an antenna. upgrade the hangar. Which was expensive. But we should now be able to launch no problem. Yep. That makes sense. Let's go to the moon. This is going to be a challenge. No SAS. No SAS, no node planner. This is just eyeball. All right. Here we go. See, I'm pushing the no SAS. Oh, check my staging. And there we go. Yep, 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 yep. Nope. Yep. Okay. Here we go. Should have all the Delta V in the world though once we get there. Yeah, well, actually, we'll have to do one partial orbit before we can transfer to the moon. That's not a problem. Let me get these open and get a little bit of science out of this thing. Oh, I've already done that one. Okay. Now we're just riding. And in order to turn, I have to fire up that engine. It's the only orientation control I have. Now, we just need to time warp until we're in the correct orientation for a transfer. So basically what I want to do is wait until I see the moon come up over the horizon and then burn straight at it. We will not move straight at it, but that's how we want to burn. And there it is. A little more. Okay, that's good. Very small amount of thrust. And That should be it. That should be our moon encounter. One way to find out. Come on, moon. I don't know. Oh, you know what I could do right now? I could get some space high above Kerbin science. And there we go. Now, can I turn this into an orbit for a bonus? Let's find out. Well, I can grab some science from the moon. This is high above the moon. Yep. Okay. Right about there. Start a burn. Burn completely in the wrong direction, but again, it's the only way I can move. I have no SAS. There we go. We got an orbit of the moon. Let's take it into a low orbit so I can get science from space near the moon. There, that should do it. And yeah, I believe we've finished the contract. Just circle around until we're low. Grab that science. If I can, I might not be able to. And I waited too long. I have no connection. Oh well. Do another orbit. This, yeah, I don't have the electric charge to be doing this. Oh well, maybe in the future we'll fly out here and throw some solar panels on this guy. Again, this is now a permanent satellite, so I'm open to ideas for names, but I think that's a great place to call it. I accomplished my goals for tonight. So thank you for watching. Glad you could join me. Have a good night.